Dear students, welcome back to my YouTube channel Remedial Classes. Today I will be taking a chapter, the Berger, which is of standard 12. So let's begin the story. The story is the Berger by William Somerset Maugham. William Somerset Maugham was a 20th century writer, okay? And William Somerset Maugham, before coming into the field of writing, he was a physician, but he had a great taste for writing, so he came into the writing, okay? And he was a very successful man. People liked his writing very much, okay? So let's enjoy the story, what the story deals with. So the story deals with the Berger. The Berger. Now, first of all, the title itself, heading itself suggests the Berger. So, we would first of all try to know what is a Berger. So, a Berger means caretaker of the church. Okay. The story is about the caretaker of the church. Where is the church located? The church is located at St. Neville Square. Okay. So, St. Neville Square, London. Okay. And the parishioners, means the people who lives around the church, they were very sophisticated, educated people, sophisticated in the sense, they were very cultured, educated, healthy, wealthy, everything. So, they were very sophisticated class. They used to come to the church. It's a very, means a popular church. That is why all the high class people come to the church. Okay. And now, the story is about the Berger and Vicar. So there were two vicars, old vicar and the new one. So the problem now is with the new vicar. The new vicar, who has come from East End, he was a red-faced, young, energetic man, around 42 years, very energetic and strong. And he also comes from the educated class. Okay, he deals with educated people. So he is a bit of different type. So let's begin the story. The story begins with the christening of the child. Christening means baptizing the child. Okay, baptizing the child means christening them, making them Christians. Okay, which is called Namkaran, you know. In we Hindu people do Namkaran, so in this way. So there were like Namkaran going on in the church. And the vicar, what happened, the Berger, the story starts with the Berger and a bit a description about him. It is mentioned in the story in the first page. You will see that the Berger, he used to love his dress very much. Okay, and on that christening ceremony, he was wearing his second best dress. Okay, he has first best dress, second best dress. So that day he was wearing the second best dress. Some of the things I have written on the board, I think you can see. Okay, I wrote about the Berger, Vicar, what all the meanings. I think you can follow it. So now second best dress he wore, and he loved his dress so much that he maintains it so well. And in the evening, when he has to undress this dress and wear his formal dress for going home, you know, at that time he used to feel like ill-clad. Ill-clad means like he is not clad, not dressed well. Okay, he feels like, oh, I am not dressed up properly, like that. Money, he likes his dress so much. And and then he had been working in that church for a period of about 16 years. You know, 16 years is such a long period, and every year he gets a new dress, new gown, and the old one, the worn out one, he never throws them away. He keeps it very well. Okay, he presses them and then wraps it up in a brown paper, and that, and then keeps it in the wardrobe. Okay, in this way he loves his dress. And his dress, though made of alpaca, you know, alpaca means a woolen sheep, which is extracted, the wool which is extracted from sheep. But his dress is though it is made of alpaca, the way he maintains his dress, you know, it seems as if it is made of bronze. Okay, so shiny, so clean, you know, like if you are a school going or a college going student, you know, if how you suppose if you love your college, what would you do? You would maintain your dress. Okay, because in that dress you look good. Then you would, what would you do? You would wash it yourself, you will press it, and then you will not even allow a spot, even if you will not allow a spot to fall on your dress, isn't it? This is what, how we maintain our dress, if you love it. And if you do not love your dress, then you will throw it away. In this way, the Berger loves his dress. That shows his intense liking for the job which he does. Okay, he works so dedicatedly that the parishioners also loves the service provided by him in the church. Okay, so now let's continue. So what happens on that day, on the christening ceremony day, the Berger the verger was told by the biker to meet him in the vestry. Now what is vestry? Vestry means a room which is attached to the church. The room which is attached to the church, but then that room is like a storeroom, okay, where you keep all the belongings. So he was called in the vestry. So the verger actually, this new man, you know, he wants to put his finger on every pie. Means he tries to find fault with that this work is not done well, that work is not done well, in this way. But the verger was a very, very tolerant man. He tolerates everything, okay. He has the capacity to tolerate because he loves his job. So he tries that no fault can be found in his work. So now, on the day when he was called in the vestry, he was thinking, some intuition, when something is going to happen with us, we can feel the instinct, is not it? I think something is going to go wrong with me, we can feel it. In this way, the verger was also feeling that, oh my God, I think something is going to happen with me. Why am I called? But still, he said, okay, let's, whatever will happen, will happen, let me do my work, perform my duty, after that I will go. Then okay, he was thinking all this in his mind, and then he, after his work, he went to the vestry. And when he went into the vestry, surprisingly what he sees, he finds that the two wardens, okay, the male wardens, okay, two male wardens were already sitting in the vestry with the biker, okay. And then the biker called the verger, and then the biker said that, I have something to tell you which might not be pleasing to you. Then the verger was thinking that what might be there that which will not please me. Then verger said, okay sir, though he was tensed inside, but he did not show his tense, okay. He tried to maintain the dignity in his face with a smile. So the verger said that, no, I am satisfied with you, you work very well, okay. And why will he not be satisfied? Moreover, the verger was a very well accomplished man, very meticulous man. He performs his duty very well. Moreover, he was a very handsome man, which is described in the story that he looks like an actor who can perform the task of a duke, like in a drama, like this. Means that one I'm explaining. Like suppose you have seen Mahabharata. Okay, the Mahabharata you see, and in Mahabharata you see the Nitin Bharat, one who played the part of our Lord Krishna. The part which was played by him, we feel that might be Lord Krishna, might be like that. He is so much suited, okay, handsome man. Then you can see, like in Ramayana, you see Arun Govind, who played the part of Ram. He looked exactly, sometime back it was shown in the TV, is not it, last year. So Ram was looking exactly like Ram. We feel that Ram would look like him, Sita would look like her, Lakshman would be like that, Ravan would be like that. You can imagine like that. So he was also like that, very handsome man. Moreover, he is very meticulous man. So now going back a bit to the history of the verger, the verger actually started his work at the age of 12, and when he started his work, he worked as a page boy. Page boy, means attendant. Means in a restaurant, you see there are attendants. If you go to a restaurant, somebody will welcome you with well dressed, maintained with a smile. They will welcome you, welcome sir, and then these are called page boy. Okay, so he was a page boy to a merchant, and then later on he became a single handed butler to a widowed woman. Widowed peeress. Okay, so to a widowed woman, he worked completely single. He used to manage her house completely by himself. So because of his hard work and his love towards his work, he kept on rising, and he has risen up to the level of a verger, of a Saint Nevilles Ware, such a famous one. Okay, because of his hard work. So now that is why the verger was a bit sad now, because the biker, after the arrival of this new biker, some complications are going on with him. So now the new biker was telling that, so I give you 3 months time to learn how to read and write. I have problem with you because you don't know how to read and write. So the verger was saying that though I don't know reading and writing, the old biker was well known to my educational status that I don't know how to read and write, but there was no problem. I did my duty very well. The biker had no problem. But this new biker said, but I have a problem. So if you don't know how to read and write, and even the wardens, They were also questioning him, if you don't know reading and writing in this age, is it not difficult? How do you manage? Then this Bharjar said, no, I manage. I can read through pictures. Whatever is read through pictures, I can understand what is going on. So, okay, through pictures you understand, it is okay. But then if you have to write a letter or read a letter, what do you do? At that time, the Bharjar said that there is also no problem because my wife is a bit scholar. Means my wife is... knows how to read and write, she is a scholar, so she reads it for me or she writes for me, I have no problem. But then the biker said, no, it is not possible. I give you 3 months time. Within 3 months time you learn how to read and write, you learn the letters, otherwise you have to lose the job. Then the Bharjar said that the Bharjar was intensely sad, but then he said that how can I learn how to read and write? Because once a cook tried to teach me, but then I could not. I have no knack for it. I have no knack for it means I have no interest for that, because all the learnings are for taste only. Okay, for living in this practical world, learning is not so much necessary. And the Bharjar was saying, but then the biker was not satisfied. Biker said, I give you 3 months time. If you cannot, you may quit the job. Then the Bharjar, he accepted. He said that, no, I cannot read how to read and write. And with full dignity, though he loved the job, he was ready to resign. Because now it is not possible for him at such age to learn how to read and write. So he said that, I will tender my resignation. Okay. So the Bharjar now he was going to resign from the job. So now after leaving the charge, you know, every day after leaving the church, he goes home and his wife, she waits for him with a cup of hot tea, and both of them enjoy the time. But on that day, the Bharjar was in a very sad mood, so he was not intending to go to his house. There were two roads, and so he followed the other one, which does not lead to his house. He was going through the another road, and while going, you know, while going in a mood of thinking that what would I do now, I cannot come down to the domestic work. Once I have become the Bharjar of a particular church or a particular famous church, now how can I work as a domestic type of work, like these things I cannot do. Now the money also which I have saved, how would it run for a long time? For some time it will run, but then within a short span of time it will be spent. So how would I run my family? In this way he was thinking and walking down the long street of London. Okay, so when he was walking through the long street, suddenly he felt like smoking. So he wanted gold flakes. Gold flakes, you know, a brand of cigarette, name of the company, the Gold Flakes. Okay, like Godrej company, so the Gold Flakes company, it's a cigarette company. So he wanted to take a cigarette, but then he was looking here and there, but not a single shop was available on that place. So suddenly an idea flashed into his mind and he said that, yes, I got an idea. So immediately he turned back and went back to his house, where his wife was waiting for him with a cup of tea. Then both of them had taken the tea. Then the wife was asking him, what problem you have? He did not disclose everything to her. And then the idea which had flashed into his mind was that he would open what? Cigarette shop and news agent. And he would become a news agent in the long street of London. So what happened? In the long street of London, whenever he found a vacant room, he rented it and became a cigarette. He started his cigarette business. But within a short period of time, he was earning so much. He was giving such a great sale. Then he started next one. And in this way, he was getting richer and richer because he was very dedicated towards his work. So within a period of 1 year, he had 10 shops in the long street. Wherever he found a long street and no shops, he opened a shop and managed with a manager. And in this way, he became so rich. He was earning hand over fist, means his fist could not hold the money. It was so much more. Okay, $30,000 he was earning. And so every weekend he had to collect the money and go to the bank to deposit it. So one morning, the cashier said that our manager wants to meet you. So he is not a Bharjar, he is a businessman, well established businessman, Albert was thinking, why is the manager calling me, but then he went into the manager's room. Manager was very happy to see such a great man. He shook his hands and then told that you are earning so much, around $30,000. So why don't you invest it in the share market? So the Berger was saying that Albert was saying that no, I am not interested in all this. I don't want to invest my money in the share market. Then the bank manager said, no problem, we will do everything for you. We will manage all the papers, everything. You just sign it. And at that time, the Berger had to disclose that he did not know how to read and write. He said that, sir, sorry to say, but I don't know how to read and write. At that time, the manager, he's flung from this chair. He jumped from his chair, and he was looking at this Albert like a prehistoric monster, in before history. And it means old ancient demon. But what in the manager was shocked that even in this age there may be people who does not know how to read and write. So the manager was totally shocked, and then the manager said, okay, though you do not know how to read and write, but you are earning such a huge sum of money, what would you have done if you were literate, if you knew how to read and write? At that time, the Berger, he smiled and said, I would have become the Berger of St. Nebula Square. Okay, means the Albert liked being a Berger still. Okay, he loved the job so much. So this is the end of the story. What did you learn from this story, students? Here are, I think you can learn two things. One thing is that if you are hardworking, and if you are hardworking, and if you have a practical knowledge, then even though not literate, one can earn a large sum of money. One can reach the zenith. The sky would be unlimited for him or her. Okay. So from this story, you learn this one, that we have to be hardworking. You have to be very hardworking in whatever field you do. If you are a student, you read hard. Okay. If you want to open a business, you do it. Well, whatever you do, you should be dedicated, then that will definitely bring success in one's life. Okay, this was for today. Thank you.